welcome, thanks for stopping by. It's time to learn with our friend Clive. So grab your brush, have a great time. And don't forget.
Hello and welcome back to the studio. I'm going to get straight into this 15 by 12 canvas panel, which I take a liberty of doing a quick sketch, and I put a burnt umber ground on there. That's just a very thin coat of burnt umber just to tone back the canvas. Now you can see the colours that I've got listed up there on the wet palette. And I've got a couple of blues, a red, a yellow, yellow ochre, and a black and some burnt umber for my darkening colours, and a little bit of white by there. I've also got some thickening agent, which is available on my website. That actually thickens up the paint, because I'm going to use paint a little bit thicker today, and I'll show you exactly how that works as we progress. I got my new bowls now. I've got a medium mix flow improver in there, and that's all available on the website. So we'll tell you no more about that. Palette knife and a couple of brushes. Okay, so I'm working off a reference photograph that is a royalty-free image, which will be posted on the website, along with a drawing of that, so it's easier for you to follow along if that's what you want to do. And this series, I've decided to do a little bit thicker paints and a little bit more of a brush stroke, rather than thin layers, which I normally do. Okay, so without further ado, let's get straight to the palette. And I got some Ceylon Blue, which I'm going to thicken up. You can see it's quite thin. Okay, so I'm going to half that there, because I want a little bit thin. I want a little bit of the thinner colour remaining. But I'm doing it this way because I want to show you how this actually thickens it up. So make sure you clean your palette knife off, because you don't want to contaminate this. And you only need a small amount of that thickening agent, again, which is available on the website. There's two sizes, there's a 20mm and there's a 100mm. If you're not sure, try the 20mm first. If you place an order, add that into your order and give it a try. And if you like it, then we can send you a bigger one out, 100mm out. And you can see it's going to thicken my paint. Now, you can use this in any paint. So if you've got a cheap budget paint, you can thicken your paint up really, really well with that. Look, there's only a small amount of thickening agent that has thickened that up. And not only that, it actually retards it as well. So you can have a little bit more playing time. Okay, so we need to get a little bit of ultramarine blue as well. So I'm just going to put my ultramarine blue by there, and just leaving a little bit of the normal ultramarine blue behind. Again, wiping my palette knife off. And I'll show you once more. Just get a small amount. You don't want a lot of this. A small amount of that into the paint. It's not going to colour shift. In other words, it's not going to change the value of that paint. All it's going to do is give you a nice, thick paint. And you need to mix that in really, really well. There you go. Mix it in really, really well. Well, I might have just added just a little bit too much in there. So let's just get some more ultramarine blue over. So you said you only want a small amount, a pea size really. That's all you want, a small amount of paint. Anyway, mix that in really well. And that's what I'm going to be doing throughout this process. I'm not going to waste too much video time at the moment with that. So I'm just going to clean off my palette knife. And let's move in onto this painting. Now you can do this with a palette knife or you can do it with a brush. I'm going to do it with a brush today. There we go, why not? So I'm just going to pick up a little bit of the Ceylon Blue, just a neat Ceylon Blue without the thickening agent in. And I'm just going to just put in a bit of blue in like this. Just put that down on top of that burnt umber like that. And as I said, I am following a reference. Let's get a little bit of that blue over there. I'm just add a little bit of white to it. I just want to lighten it off a touch. There we go. And just put that in as well. And just spread that around. Like that. Put down your lighthouse. There you go. I'm playing around with colours this last couple of months. And this is a new year, as you know. And I'm just playing around with a little bit of colour here and there. And seeing what we can actually do is leave a little bit of that burnt umber showing through, because we can add some yellows and whites and things in there. Let's get a little bit of ultramarine blue into the top of this sky now, just just to give us a guide on where we want things to go. There we go. Don't forget, down to the horizon, it gets a little bit lighter. So we can bring a little lad, ultramarine blue, which is quite a nice purpley type of colour. It really is. It's a nice warm colour. And always got some kitchen roll in my hand, in a bit of white, just to lighten that off. I'm bringing a bit of that down. We can put some footy eels in there in a second. And this is just a block out. We're just getting some colour into this sky, so we know where things are going to be. And we can bring a little bit of that colour down. Let's just put a little bit more white to it. Colour down there. There you go. Just put a little bit more white to that. Let's bring a little bit of colour down. We want a little bit of a lighter horizon down there. And last year, I actually went to Fishguard, which is a place down in West Wales. And if anybody is from Wales or the UK, then you should know roughly where Fishguard is, because it's one of the ports where the yacht, it's a ship. What do they call them, Clive? I don't know. It's not a ship. It's one of them things that go across to Ireland. And I'm actually going to go to Ireland this year. I'm looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to Ireland this year. So I'm just putting a little bit of colour into this water. Don't worry too much about covering everything. It's just an idea of where things are going to be for us. And we can build the colour up as we progress. And if you've never painted before, you can do this. You can try. My lessons are designed to inspire you. And try doing things that you're uncomfortable with. Because that way, you always get better. You can't get worse. Trust me, we all think we can't get worse. We can always get better. And that's a good thing with these things. And it's important that you remember that. So I don't like to put, I don't like to say, oh, this is an intermediate, this is advanced, this is you know, an easy one, or it's a middle one. And I don't like labelling, I don't like labelling work like that. Why? Let me answer the question for you. The reason that I don't like doing that is because you're putting a label on yourself, and by saying it's easy, you feel a lot easier knowing that you can do it. If I said this is an easy painting, you'll have a try. If I said it was an intermediate, you'd think, oh, well, I'm not that good yet. I'm losing my headphones. I'm not that good yet, so I might try it next time. And if I say this is advanced, you might go, oh, I won't try that. I won't try that because it's too difficult. None of my paintings are difficult to do. You just need the confidence and the belief that you can do them. That's all it is. So I'm just going to throw in a little bit of, to see how I'm doing it. It's this confidence to put in these marks like that. It's all you need is confidence. All you need is confidence. And that's what we're going to do there. We're going to leave. Oh, let's get a little bit more blue down here. Let's get a little bit more. Let's get a little bit of that ultramarine blue in there. Let's darken that sky up a bit. This, I don't know. This could be a stormy sky, or it could be a summer sky. It could be anything you want it to be. You need to make that decision. You need to think about that. Now, what I'm going to do, once I finish this little bit by here, I'm going to put a little video up in a second, and I'm going to show you what Fishguard looks like. Because I said this video was made last year. And I've got some lovely ideas like this I've been meaning to get to do. I just haven't had the time. But at the moment, have a little look at that. I'm gonna put that up in the top corner by there, and have a look at that while I just continue to do this. And I'm gonna clean my brushes and thicken up a couple of paints, I think. let that play through. And let's go straight into this thick paint now. Let's get straight into this thick paint. In fact, I want to lighten some of this down like that and try and smooth it out. I put a little bit too much of my paint thickener in there. Again, as I said, it's that one there, which is available on the website, www.clive5art.co.uk. So go and find that. So I'm loading my brush up really well. You can use a really heavy, thick, heavy-duty acrylic paint for this. But why go to the expense of that when all you need is 100 grams of that and some ordinary paints, and you'll save yourself a fortune in the long term. And now I'm just going to put in some brush strokes like that. I'm not thinking too much about it. This is going to be like an oil painting, really, if you think about it. This is the effect we need to try and get from this, and just build it up like that, and get all these colours to mix together. There we are. Let's put in some lovely colours in there, and let's get some of this lovely cerulean blue. Again, washing my brush, just picking up that paint directly off the canvas, off the palette, and just find some shapes, and just don't really think about painting. I don't want you to think about painting. What I wanted to do is just make little shapes like this, and think, oh, I know, let's put a little bit of darker colour by there, and get that then, and mix that together with the cerulean blue, and just try and get that effect of it all blending, and get these lovely, lovely brush marks. And you can add different amounts of white to different, adding different amounts of white to your different blues are going to give you different values of blue, and you're going to get that little purpley colour in there as well. So just let it play, put it where you want to put it, don't think about it, just sit back and just put these little marks in like that and think, yeah, that's going to look nice there, and bring that down. And you can get acrylic paint to work very similar to oil paints, and you can get that, those brush strokes as well. There you go. How's that looking? It's looking good, isn't it? Let's get a little bit more dark. Let's get a little bit more dark in that sky like that. There you go. And you might be saying, well, what about the clouds, Clive? Well, just get a little bit of white paint on your brush, and just bring in some clouds like this, and just touch them into the sky, very, very lightly touch them into the sky. Take a little bit off, blend them through like that. Just get them in there. It's going to be nice. It doesn't matter about how dark or how light the sky is. All we're looking for is those shapes that we come to expect on a nice summer's day or a cloudy day even. You know, it could be raining. We don't know. We just make these impressionistic marks. That's all you're looking for, is an impression of what a cloud is. So you're actually painting clouds as such, are we? All we're doing is painting an impression of a cloud, and this is what we want. So bring that colour. I'm doing this very quick, so you need to spend a little bit more. I keep saying this all the time. You need to spend so much time on this, and you could do this easy. Whoops, a little bit too thick. Doesn't matter. Take a little bit off. Save it onto your tissue paper and then get that in and just use that. Spread it on. Leave a little bit of the canvas showing. Who cares? A little bit darker here and there. Spread that in. Move it about. Fill it in. Fill that sky in. With a nice, light sky. Let's get some white. Let's bring a bit of that white in. Maybe a bit too much white, Clive, it doesn't matter. Just get a little bit of blue and bring that blue in and put those marks in. Don't paint flat. Just let that brush marks just zing like that. You can use a different brush. Try using a couple of different brushes. Don't have to just use one brush. I'm just using one brush today. I don't know. I might change over and get another brush in a second. Who knows? I certainly don't know. Let's put another cloud up there. Let's just whiff it in like that. We don't know. A bit brighter in one corner like that. We don't know if it's a cloud or what. Who knows? Merge that in then. Blend that in. Get a little bit more colour. Darken the bottom of that sky. There we are. Just an impression of some clouds in the sky. An impression of clouds in the sky. Now, once your brush becomes a little bit thick, then you can either wash it out or you can just use another brush. That's what I do. Yes, and then just build up this lovely sky like that. Leave some brush marks. You want those brush marks to show through. You really do. And just paint with love, paint with joy, paint away that stress of everyday life, as you do with me here in Wales. And this is a lovely place to relax, Tenby. I go to Tenby every year and I really enjoy it down there. And I take my little dog Molly with me, and she has a little run around on the beach, and she really, really enjoys it. She really does. So there we go. That's looking quite nice. Let's get some colour in the sky now. Just merge in that blue in like this. Just get a little bit of that ultramarine blue and darken a couple of sections of the sky up. There we go. We said we're going to put some more cloud over this way, so let's just put some cloud in like this. I don't know. Wherever. You decide. You've got to decide where these things live in your world. I just make this up as I go along. And as I said, this is a royalty-free image that I've got off one of the royalty-free sites that I go to, and they are listed down there in the descriptions for you. Please go along and check them out. I will put this image up on the website, www.clive5art.co.uk. Go into there and go into tracings. Let's just carry on with that. I'm going to leave a couple of areas showing through, because I want to warm this guy up in a second. I'm going to just bring that down there like that. I'm going to pick up a little bit of burnt umber just on the tip of my brush. I still got the blue on there. I'm going to put some foothills in, because where I live, which is not too far from the coast, and there's a little place called Puthcawl, as they actually say in Wales. And this reminds me of Puthcawl, because the Lighthouse is only a smaller version of that, but it looks very similar. But then it could be anywhere, couldn't it? It could be just in your imagination. Who knows? That's fine. That's fine also. Just put some lighter marks here and there and there and here like that. And let's just get some darker bits of sky to merge in. There we go. Doesn't matter. You make it up as you go along. Blend it in. Get some nice cerulean blue. Just put that into the sky like that. And leave a couple of areas, because we're going to warm that sky up later on. Again, this time, let's do the sea. But this time, just lay the paint this way. You can put squiggly marks if you want to, but lay the paint that way, adding a little bit more white to the paint. Now you experiment with this. And just let the sky come through into that water, and just drag in that water. Let's just get a little bit of purpley blue, ultramarine blue type of colour, just to put a little bit of shadow in that water there like that. just a little bit of shadow in that water, dragging it through like that. Very similar to oil painting, isn't it? It's an easy way to learn to paint. And I want you to try and do this if you can. Now, if, as I said, you can try this with just ordinary acrylics. You don't need to use the thickening agent. But what you're going to do is you're going to find that it's going to be a little bit flat. And you don't want that. You could also try and do this with a palette knife, which works just as nice. But just get a little bit of texture in there, like that. That's looking quite nice, I think. Just get a little bit of texture in there. And let's lighten this up even more now. And let's bring in a bit of... Now, what's the opposite? What's the opposite of blue? Do anybody know what the opposite of blue is? If you've painted with me before, you know I like painting with compliments. So I think orange would be a good compliment to this painting. And it just happens to be orange in this reference that I've got. But if I was painting this myself, then that's exactly what I would do. I would put a nice orange in. And that's what we're going to do in a second. So let's just continue putting in some little light reflections. Just dragging the brush very, very lightly through like that, just to get a little bit of light. And my seat is creaking. Just get a little bit of light in there like that. Don't worry too much about this, that and the other, because it doesn't really matter, does it? No, it doesn't. Okay, now this is going to take a little bit longer to dry than normal because we've got that thickening agent in there. Now I'm picking up another short flat and I want to make up some orange, so let's get some yellow, a lot of yellow. There we go, a lot of yellow. I'm going to bring a little bit of yellow ochre into it, just because I want to. And a touch of red. Just a touch of red. I'm going to want to make an orange. Just another touch of red. Shouldn't use a brush to mix your paints with. And why not? I don't mind. You can do whatever you want. It's your painting. It's your studio. You do whatever you want to do. Don't let anybody tell you you can't, because you can. You can do anything you want. Now, I've never actually tried mixing this with a brush, so let's, for argument's sake, let's see if we can pick up a bit of that with a brush, a small amount, and let's just mix that in. I guess my brush is going to get all nice and thick, which it is, so I don't recommend you using a, knife for that. So let's just scrape that off my brush. There we are. It doesn't matter. And let's just mix that in. There we go. Nice thick. Look how nice that is. Nice and thick. And that's a good way of saving yourself some money also. Let's get some of that on my brush. Right now, clean my palette knife off. And let's get some orange in there. Ooh, look at that. Yes. Nice and thick. Put some orange in there. Just lay it in. Let's lay that orange in that water. And that's gonna go really nice with that. Nice and thick. We want texture in our water. Again, don't be afraid to put in nice texture marks. Let's get some paint. In this wall. There you go. Try using a palette knife. Palette knife works well. I'm going to have a look at that bolt in a minute, because I'm not happy with the way that bolt is there. Let's get a little bit of ordinary yellow and just put in some shapes and highlights and things there. Let's bring a bit of that yellow down then. Down there like that. Mixing a bit of that yellow and that. Nice thick paint together. Let's put a bit of an outcrop there with that. We can work on that in a second. Just bring that across there. A bit more red. Let's just darken that up. Use that as a shadow colour. And just put in blocks of colour here and there, just to sharpen that up. There we are, let's do that. Bit more red down there just to darken that up. I'm just gonna get a little bit of burnt umber on the tip of my brush. I'm just gonna run through like as if there's maybe a walkway there or something. There you go. Put a bit of that colour now into this water. There you go. Wiping my brush. I'm just going to get my palette knife and I want to thicken up a little bit of red, so I'm going to bring a bit of red over there. As you can see, I'm not going to use a lot. I'm going to use a very small amount of the thickening agent. Maybe just a touch more. Try not to contaminate that if you can help it. It's better to mix and use a little bit at a time rather than try and mix loads of it, because what you don't want is to waste this stuff. That's important. Let's just get a little bit of this red now. Put that there like that. We're going to put a bit of red I forgot to say, you can actually thin it as well. If you find this a little bit thick, you can add a little bit of water, or if you've got any of my medium mix, and you can use a bit of my medium mix as well. And what that's going to do is actually thin it down a touch for you. Okay. So this, a little bit of burnt umber again. I just want to maybe just darken up section, and please bear with me. This is a quick painting, something like this can take a while, but as you know, but please bear with me. There we go, a little bit of shadow in that water there, like that. Okay, let's bring a little bit more of this blue in now, and let's bring that blue across. And what we want to do is get a little bit of white. A white and blue, and then just bring that watermark. Try and keep it as straight as you can. There we are. Put a bit of that colour. Getting a little bit of that orange to reflect into that water, which is going to go a little bit greeny colour. So don't be afraid of that. Let's get a bit of white. We've got the blue on, blah, blah, blah. We can get a blue on our brush now, and this is not going to be so thick, but let's just touch in the lighthouse with some white. You can thicken this white up if you want to. I've opted not to. If you find this a little bit thin, Just thicken it up a touch. I'm going back into a little bit of that blue. And I'm going to go back into this side now and just put some shadow on it. Maybe just a touch more blue, maybe a little bit of ultramarine blue, just to give me that shadow. A little bit more ultramarine blue then. Maybe just underneath like that. I want a bit more. There we go. Let's put a little bit of burnt umber now just on the tip of that brush just to get this top done like that. Maybe just a touch of burnt umber there. You can put a bit of just the smallest amount of black, just a touch of black, just to maybe just put a dough in or something there. Here we are. We're looking for impressionism. A little bit of shadow in. There we go. You want a little bit more red. I'm using the same brush. Not down. Just a multitude of colours on this brush. And this is something you could do if you're just sitting down. Maybe you've gone for a walk. Maybe you're at the beach. Maybe anything like that. You could do something like this. Just in this style, I mean, now. You don't need all the gumph. Like loads of brushes. And so far, I'm just using one brush. And you can get a little bit of white. And this is the type of thing you could do out in the field if you wanted to. This is the type of thing you could do out in the field. There you go. Can you do this? I think you can. I think you can do this. There's no reason why you can't do this. Absolutely no reason whatsoever. There you go. Okay, let's get a bit of yellow in this sky. Is it going to go green? Does it matter? I don't mind if it does. Let's just get a little bit of yellow. Let's just get that little bit of warmth in this sky. I don't know, just to balance things out maybe. I don't know. Who knows? I don't know. Just ordinary plain yellow down here now. Mix that in with our paint. It's still wet. It's still going to be wet. Just mix it in. We've got our boat there now. We need to add a little bit of white to that yellow. Orangey colour. And let's just put the cabin in place. There we go. Let's put a... Just look at the brush strokes I'm making. Quite easy. Easy brush strokes. That's all they are. Impressionism. It's not easy to say. Impressionism. Are we going to put another boat there? We could put another boat there, I suppose. Let's see what we can do. Let's put his bow in there and just flick him in. There we go. Let's put a little bit of shadow just on the other side of that. I don't know, is it call it a keel? I don't know. And we got, let's give him a nice red. Cabin, I think. And let's just put a few. Strokes in there like that. Can you see that? Does that look pretty good? I don't know. I may have spoilt that now. But I'm going to keep on with it. I don't care. There you go. It doesn't matter. Let's get some water. line in there. Let's get this orange. Maybe that's what's causing us the problem then. Maybe that's what's causing us the problem. Let's get a little bit of that stuff. Let's thicken that up. A little bit of red. There you go. We need to mix a bit of more orange up. There's a bit of yellow, a bit of red. This is just an ordinary yellow. Don't worry too much about specific yellows. Let's get some of that thickening agent. Let's just thicken that up. There we go. Nice. As I said, you could use a palette knife. If you wanted to, you could use a palette knife. Look. With this. I just put a few marks in there for you to show you. You could quite easily use just a palette knife. And you could get some wonderful effects with that. They're just using a blade or a knife. You could get some blue here and there. Mix that in. Don't worry if it goes a bit green. Some sea is green, isn't it? It doesn't matter, does it? There you go. There's a bit of red there. Complement the red is green. So this is going to fit. So let's get rid of that tissue paper. And let's just move a bit of this around like that. There you go. Doesn't matter if it's a little bit green in places. There we are. You can always add a little bit more yellow on top of that if you wanted to. There you go. Doesn't matter. Let's get that colour back in. Let's get some white. Let's just bring some white in. I'm going to get a little bit of black just on the tip of that brush. I want a little bit of black just on the tip of that blush. I want to put a shadow in there. And I want to darken that off there. Like that. Maybe a bit more black. Just to show some definition. And then let's just get some shadow in on that side of the boat as well. Let's put a definite line there. And then just add a little bit of shadow in on there like that. Bring a little bit of colour. And these are just easy, simple brush strokes. Look, I'm not going too mad at it. Again, all I'm doing is just using the same brushes. Again, a little bit of black now, detailing black. Just put a line like that and maybe a line going that way. And we could have a couple of windows in like that. There may be some windows there as well. Yeah, like that. Get a nice little brush. And then just put a little mast in, maybe, there. And you could have a couple of lines in there like that. And a little mast there. I don't know what's on these things. I'm not too sure myself, but there you go. And we could put a roof there. Just using this brush. There you go. And you could have a thing there, couldn't you? And you could have one of them little masts as well. I don't know what that is. Just maybe just a flagpole, or is it functional? Who knows? I don't mind. It's just representational marks. Let's get a little bit more red. And let's just 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 put a few marks here and there like that. Maybe let's put a little bit of blue. Let's just put a little bit of blue there. Just to carry that colour. We can get a bit more white. Oops, I got black on my brush. Okay, let's wash that out. I need to get a little bit more white on my palette. And this is a nice, easy, simple way to actually do a painting like this. So, have a practice. You never know until you try. You never know until you try what you can accomplish. And don't ever be afraid to attempt anything. Because that's the time you're going to stop. And don't ever limit your abilities. Another thing you mustn't do is limit your abilities. It's important that you don't do that. So rather than say, oh, I can't do that because it's hard, or I can't do that because it's an intermediate, or I can't do that because it's more advanced, don't limit the possibilities of your imagination and your skill, because the only way we can learn is by pushing ourselves a little bit more than we are used to. So let's get some colour down here. I'm just going to smooth that off just for speed of painting. I'm just going to smooth this in touch, but put your own mark on this painting. I want to see this on the Clive 5 art pages. If you want to go to YouTube, Facebook, and type in Clive 5 art family group, and then you'll see that there's a really helpful bits and pieces in there. And if you like this type of thing, let me know in the comments. And don't forget to click those iCards out. And if you click that little button down there with my thumb up, you'll also be able to subscribe. So if it's the first time you've seen one of my lessons, then please subscribe. Please comment, like, pop along to Patreon, which is a public funded site. For as little as $1 a month, you can support me here in the studio, which will help me continue these lessons. And I want to thank all my patrons that are currently there for doing that, because without you and your support, then I'm sure I'd be making a lot less videos. But continue to build this up. There you go. Continue to build that up. Using the brush in different ways. Using paint in different thicknesses. That's another brush. Another painting we've done with just one brush, I should say. So let's just put a couple of shadow marks in there. And just add some detail here and there. And there and here. Just get some shadows in. Put some shadow in down there. And you can just plod along, as they say here in Wales, as we paint in the way the stress again of everyday life, which is what I enjoy doing, as you know. And you can make this water look as choppy as you want. If you want to add a little bit more white here and there, maybe the water's just coming in, and you can increase this. And please comment on this video. I'd like to know exactly what you would think of this. And as I said, if you like this type of thing, we can certainly move on and look at different ways of doing things and improving your skills as an artist. And please subscribe as well. So all that remains me to do today really is to say thank you very much for joining me in the studio. Have a good day, a good week, a good month, a good year. Thank you very much for painting away the stress of everyday life here in South Wales. So until the next time, have fun with this. Let me know, and I will see you next time.
Hey, welcome, thanks for stopping by. It's time to learn with our friend Clive. So grab your brush, have a great time. And don't forget to click subscribe. Visit Clive5art.co.uk.